Report now, and George Morara was a member of parliament who lasted barely 9 months in the August House before death snatched him away. The young lawmaker, both in age and the political scene, is said to have given the government a 48-hour ultimatum to produce a convict who had assassinated Tom Mboya. But before the lapse of those 48 hours, Morara perished in a road accident. Was it a normal accident or was it premeditated? 51 years after his death, his daughter has embarked on a quest to establish what caused their father's death, saying all they want is closure. Duncan Khaemba brings us that report, George Morara's 48 hours ultimatum and death.
All I was hearing that he's no more, but I did not understand as a child what death meant.
Na mambo ya maendeleo, alipenda maendeleo, na alipendwa na watu sana.
He left a mark. He is the one who set up the foundation of the current Nyamira Level 5.
Daktari alifanya postmortem. Aliandika ripoti akasema kwamba ilikuwa accident.
On Saturday, 12th September 1970, curtains on the life of a young and fiery politician came down. George Justus Morara, Member of Parliament for Mugirango West, was involved in a grisly road accident at Chavakali along Kakamega Kisumu Highway when his vehicle had a head-on collision with another vehicle. The MP was driving back to his political base in the Kisii region. 51 years later, the cause of his death remains shrouded in mystery. Three things remain at the center of this mystery: a parliamentary trip to Zambia, a 48-hour ultimatum to government, and a suspicious road accident. What is the real story? Did the young Morara fly close to the scorching political sun? Was he forced into a grave early? And will the truth ever be known?
As I grew up, I kept to understand that my father was a very important person in this country. And a lot has been said by him, but not a lot has been documented. I guess maybe the circumstances surrounding his death have made it a bit difficult for a lot of people to know who he was. Because even right now, when you ask many people who are called George Morara how they came by that name, George Morara, they are not able to explain that.
Sandy Mokeira Morara is the firstborn of the late George Morara. She was 2.5 years old when the father died. Her siblings, Duke, was 1 year old, while Innocent was 5 months, and their mother, Mary, who died in 2010, was 24 years old, when the head of their family, a breadwinner, a husband, and father, died. Sandy is on a mission. 51 years later, her quest is to get closure on their father's death and wants information about his death declassified and her father honored as a hero.
And as I was growing up, I kept asking my mother, where's my father? And she had a hard time explaining to me that, of course, he's no more.
Isaiah Ongaga is the only surviving sibling of the late Morara. Their mother died when Morara was 6 months old. The last time he saw his brother alive was in 1969, as they campaigned for the Mugirango West parliamentary seat. According to Hansard records from Parliament, George Morara made his maiden speech as MP Mugirango West on 10th February 1970, as the House debated a presidential address, marking the beginning of his fiery speeches in Parliament.
Alikuwa muda mfupi, lakini alifanya mambo haraka na mambo ya maendeleo. Alipenda maendeleo na alipendwa na watu sana. Hata aliweza kutengeneza foundation ya factory ya Kibirigo. Vire na akaweka chiwe la secondary school ya Kibirigo.
In the Kusiland, or within Nyamira itself, is one man, within the 8 months, he left a mark. He is the one who set up the foundation of the current Nyamira Level 5.
In September 1970, Parliament's Committee on Social Welfare and Employment traveled to Zambia for official duty. It is said that as Morara was enjoying his evening at an entertainment joint, he came face to face with a man called Nahashon Njenga Njoroge, who had been found guilty of assassinating Tom Mboya on 5th July the previous year. According to the government, Njenga had been sentenced to death and consequently hanged for assassinating influential constitutional affairs minister Tom Mboya. Morara was in deep shock. How could a man who was supposedly hanged be merrymaking in Lusaka, Zambia? When the committee, which was chaired by Kandara Member of Parliament George Mweshigi, arrived back in the country, their first stop was Parliament, and Morara opened the Pandora's box. Government was given a 48-hour notice to produce Nahashon Njenga. The lawmaker then left the capital for Kakamega, and within the same 48 hours, he had given the government an ultimatum to produce Mboya's assassin. Morara perished in a grisly accident, a matter that raised suspicion until today. Was it a natural accident or was it premeditated? Had he stepped on some toes?
To any human being, when you look at it, that could have definitely read this death. From history and from what we see and from the history of the African governments, we feel strongly, not only as a family, as friends, that should have triggered his death from some quarters.
Unasikia tu uchungu kwa sababu tukuchua. Walisema man hata judgment ilisema ni accident. Hata state council hiyo alikuwa anauliza maswali. Alikuwa anauliza maswali, hakuna mtu wa kumuuliza mambo yote, lakini tulikuwa tu tulisikia ni ujungu peke yake. Na hiyo ikisemekana ni ajali, hatuna uwezo. Ni Mungu ndiye anajua watu.
These are some of the gaps Morara's children want them filled.
I happened to meet my late uncle Victor Kebaso, who was the older brother of my late father. He gave us bits about what surrounded his death.
George Morara had left Nairobi with his two colleagues, Nyarangi Moturi of Mugirango North and Mark Bosire of Kitutu Masaba, but the two reportedly disembarked in Nakuru after a fallout with Morara, who, upon reaching Kakamega, opted to stay at his friend's place, Ezekiel Nyarangi, who was then DC for Kakamega.
I've had the opportunity to meet Mrs. Nyarangi, the wife of the DC then. She told me that night when my father arrived, there was so much joy in their home. I understand the DC asked him not to leave, that he would wait for the next day because he also had an intention of going to Kisi, that they traveled together. But my father was quite a stubborn person. He told him, no, I've missed seeing my wife, Mary, and my mother, because I am his mother. I'm named after his mother. Yeah. So as it was, he left and he drove down to Chavakali, and that's where he met his death. I understand it was an accident, we don't know, but a few people who speak on the side say that it was a premeditated accident. We don't know whether it was a real accident or not.
On Saturday, 12th September, the youthful MP left Kakamega for his Kisii home while driving his Pujo 504, registration number KKZ058. At Chavakali Market, he had a fatal accident. His vehicle collided with a police Land Rover GK1357 that only had one occupant, the driver by the name Constable Frederick Kugo.
Tulipata ame alikuwa na aliumisika aka kwa hii pai kwa pacha upande wa kulia. Na wakati postmortem ilifanywa hata tulipewa makaratasi ya kuenda kuona wa siku ya kesi mambo ya na hata yule daktari alifanya ultimatum aliandika ripoti akasema kwamba ilikuwa accident.
On Tuesday 22nd September that year, in his communication from the chair, House Speaker Fred Matty did not mince his words, saying, and I quote, "The late Honorable George Justice Morara, member for Mugirango West, on the afternoon of Saturday 12th September, died instantly as a result of motor accident. Mr. Morara was not going for joyride when he met his death. He was in the service of this nation, having left Kakamega on his way to his constituency after a sitting of the Select Committee on Unemployment. Rarely has a man's so short career in this house left such an indelible mark on his character and devotion to duty." End of quote. It is a statement that perhaps in itself opened a can of worms against the government that was already under intense pressure. Rising on a point of order immediately, Mbita legislator Osingo Migure is captured on the Hansard stating, "Mr. Speaker, when the late Honorable Member for West Mugirango, Mr. Morara, passed away, the Voice of Kenya informed this country that Mr. Morara had an accident. His car collided with a lorry. Now, the next day, sir, we received information from the press that Morara's vehicle collided with a government Land Rover. We have two conflicting reports, and members of the public are bound to know how the MP had an accident. We do not know which one is right and which one is wrong." End of quote. In his question by private notice, then Kimilili lawmaker Elijah Mwangali said, "In view of the fact that the late Honorable Morara died in a motor accident in which a government criminal investigation department vehicle was involved, and since this vehicle was attached to the Western Provincial Police Headquarters in Kakamega, will the government assure this house that police investigations currently underway on the cause of this fatal accident shall be done by an independent police team from outside Western Province?" George Morara was buried 5 days later on 17th September, a funeral that was attended by National Assembly Speaker Fred Matty, six cabinet ministers, and a section of his fellow MPs. Morara was a beneficiary of the Tom Mboya airlift program to the United States, and it is believed his assassination in July 1969 might have been a personal loss to him, and perhaps he could have paid his ultimate price when he smoked out Mboya's killer.
He knew where he was. It was because of Mboya. Number two, as I've said from the history of people who were with him in school, they say he was a man who could fight for the justice, for the freedom of others. So the way Mboya died, maybe the way everything went on, he felt there was some injustice.
We know some of the features of political assassinations. There is sometimes a clear, there's choreography around how the death actually happened, and a reluctance, an extreme reluctance on the part of authorities to establish, to carry out independent investigations. Now, in the case of Morara, it has those features. There has been a reluctance and a delay in carrying out an independent investigation. What is the fear of for carrying out an independent investigation if that investigation doesn't have political implications?
George Kegoro, who is a human rights activist and executive director of Open Society Initiative for Eastern Africa, is pushing to have Morara's death classified as a political assassination.
If there's an allegation that this was a killing rather than just an assassination rather than just an accident, then there's a requirement and an obligation on the part of the law enforcement authorities to carry out an investigation. Criminal law, criminal offences never expire. Well, even if it's 100 years old, an investigation can be done. And if a person is found to have committed a criminal offence, however long ago that person committed the criminal offence, they can't claim the passage of time as a defence. People can be taken to court at any point in life.
Mombasa and Nakuru towns have roads named in honour of the late MP, a political leader who served in Parliament for barely 9 months. In 2020, during Mashujaa Day celebrations, George Morara was mentioned as a hero, and the following day, his daughter Sandy met President Uhuru Kenyatta in Ikonge.
There's another one who's called George Morara, was not fully recognized. Your Excellency, I met the daughter of George Morara. She's called Sandy Morara. She's somewhere here in the crowd. And she told me that her father had been remembered in Mombasa with the street, Nairobi, also there's George Morara Street, Nakuru, Kisumu, but they don't have anything here in Kisii. So I'm challenging the governor to name a street or something here in Kisii in honor of George Morara.
2020 was quite a turning point because I felt honored that I was able to be called upon to attend that function in Kisii. And then the following day, I was also invited now to meet His Excellency the President at Ikonge when we were opening the Chepilate Ikonge Chabera Road. If you go to the Hansards, that road, my late father fought for it. I was grateful to be alive to see that road was actually tarmacked, and now I even use it myself. And for him to have asked for that road to be tarmacked, and it's been tarmacked and I'm alive to see it, for me that was a plus.
Sandy is now pushing for a second meeting with the head of state that she believes will bring closure to the family.
If you would like to have a one-on-one chat just to know who George Morara was, and now he's meeting the daughter, then we can always have a discussion around that area. And for him also, maybe it will be a good time for it to rest, to give it closure on his side and on my side.
This is the house of the late former Member of Parliament for West Mugirango, George Morara, who died in 1970. And to my left, his grave. The distance between the house and the grave, too close. Perhaps symbolic of the 48-hour period between the time he gave the ultimatum to the government to the time he died. Duncan Khaemba, KTN News, from West Mugirango Constituency, Nyamira County.